You mentioned customers, and you've got the hospitals, healthcare organisations, and your customers in that way. And then there's also the recipients, the patients that have access to this vital equipment, which can be life-saving in many cases. Do you see any barriers on how they feel about refurbished equipment, or yes. What sort of thoughts do they have and responses?
Some of the times it's just a perception barrier. We have grown in a world where we perceive that what has been used is not good enough, without actually understanding the functioning, neither the capability or capacity of that device. So yes, one of the main issues is the perception from customers, and in our industry, I would say mainly from emerging economies. And I think that's a normal reaction, because obviously a lot of them may, or they would like to have, you know, the technology that they have seen in what we call the developed world. And they want to have access to this technology, and therefore new is important. However, it is not about new, or it is about the access, as we have explained before, of to the technology and the capabilities. So we need to change that perception with the customers and the users. The other piece is the trading policy in the world. I know waste has been dumped in emerging economies, and we shouldn't do that. Producers should be responsible of what they put into the market. However, when you want to do parts harvesting or refurbishing, you will need to move parts from one country to another one in order to make sure that you fulfill the demand, because you may not have supply and demand in the same country. In order to balance this, you may need to move components from one place to another one. And we don't have now, let's say, a free market yet for pre-owned equipment. And the third one that I would say, the third challenge, it is as related to the question that you mentioned before. I think if you really want to run a circular economy business, it needs to be a strategic decision that is shared through the top management of the organization and defines processes, capacity and capability to execute in relation to that strategy. So we see that that's not always the case.